What to expect in Paris, France. Here we are, bienvenue sur ma chaîne Travel 195. And that means, hey guys, welcome to my channel Travel 195. In our last episode, we discussed the top 10 things to do in Paris. Now you've just arrived in Paris and are hungry for real food. It's a shame because Paris has a lot to offer when it comes to cuisine. But how do you know where to go? What are the best ways to navigate the city? It can be overwhelming if you're new to Paris, and if you're not sure where to start, we've got some tips. Number 1, an excellent time to visit is during the off-peak season. Paris is a city of culture and history, but it also loves to play with the seasons. As you're planning your trip, be sure to check out the off-peak season. You'll find that Paris is full of charm even when it isn't at its peak. Paris is a great place to visit during off-peak season, especially if you want to explore the city on foot. Peak season is just from June to the end of October, so it's essential to plan. If you want to avoid fighting crowds or waiting in long lines, consider visiting during the off-peak season. You'll still see all of Paris's attractions at less crowded times and take advantage of all special events or festivals happening throughout the year. Number 2. Choose a hotel that is located near the center of the city. Paris is a fantastic city, but it's hard to get around if you need to know where to go. The easiest way to save time and money when you're visiting is to book a hotel near the city center. The closer your hotel is to the center of Paris, the more likely you will be within walking distance of all the must-see attractions. Not only will this make your trip more accessible, but it will also ensure you have plenty of time to enjoy your stay in Paris. If you want the most of your stay in Paris, you should find accommodation that fits your budget and interest. The following tips will help you make the most out of your time in Paris. Booking online is the best way to find the best hotel room at the best price. When you book online, you cannot say exactly how much each type of accommodation will cost. The average cost of a budget or economy hotel in Paris is around 100 euros a night, while the price of a budget or economy hotel in France is around 70 euros. These are basic accommodations. It is common for a very comfortable hotel to cost 170 euros a night in Paris and 150 euros out of the city. While the most expensive deluxe category hotels can cost anywhere from 450 euros in Paris to 300 euros outside the city. It is important to note, however, that the prices listed are average, so ranges can vary widely. Number 3. Wear comfortable shoes. Paris is a city that can be romantic, exciting, and even a little stressful, but it's also one of the most beautiful places on earth. Why not make every moment of your trip count? One way to do that is to wear comfortable shoes. Yes, you will want to walk all over Paris, but if you're in pain or tired after hours of walking, your trip will be less enjoyable than it is. So pack your comfortable shoes, and don't forget socks, and make sure you have plenty of time before your flight home to get some rest so that you'll be ready for the next adventure. Number 4. It is recommended to use public transport whenever possible. Paris is a great city to travel to by public transportation. If you're new to the city, you may enjoy the ease with which you can move around by train and bus. The first thing to know is that there are two types of trains, suburban trains and intercity trains. Suburban trains are slower but more frequent. Intercity trains are faster but less frequent. You can't simply buy a ticket for your trip. You have to buy an all-zone pass before getting on the train. All-zone passes allow you to use all types of trains throughout France, including suburban and intercity trains. You can also buy tickets for individual trips on every train, but if you do, you'll have to pay extra for those trips. Paris is known for its love of everything French, but also for its love of travel. Paris has excellent public transportation, so great that some travel critics call it the best in the world. But if you're visiting Paris and want to get around quickly and cheaply, you have a few options. First, you can take the metro or RER, a train like a subway. The cost depends on how far you need to go, but think about 2 euros per trip or less. Second, there's the Navigo card. This is like a bus pass. You can use it for unlimited rides on buses throughout Paris and many other cities in France. It costs 22.80 euros for 1 week of unlimited travel, 5 euros for the card itself, which means that spending at least a whole week in Paris will save you money over using cash or credit cards. Number 5. Learn the basics of French phrases by putting them into practice. Whether you're visiting Paris for a few days or an extended stay, it's essential to practice some basic French phrases. Here are our top tips for making the most of your time in Paris. Bonjour, which means hello or good day. It's always nice to say bonjour before you start speaking French. It will help you sound more natural and also help others understand that you understand what they're saying. Plus, it gives everyone a chance to smile at each other. Merci. If you're unsure what to say next, say merci. It's like saying thanks in English, which means the same thing. So people will understand what you mean anyway. Je suis désolé, je suis désolé. If someone bumps into you while they're walking and they apologize by saying je suis désolé instead of je suis désolé, then they are saying I'm sorry. You should do the same thing if someone bumps into you. Number 6. It is vital to keep your clothes in style. Paris is a fashion city, but it's also a city of history. So to be a tourist in Paris, you must have some sense of style, but that doesn't mean you have to be boring. As a rule of thumb, the French love fashion and style. So if you want to look your best while exploring the City of Light, then make sure you wear more than just jeans and a t-shirt. We put together a list of suggestions on what to wear in Paris. Jeans are great for walking around town, but they're only sometimes practical when it comes to sightseeing. Instead, try wearing pants with an elastic waistband like Lee jeans or pants that zip up at the ankles, like Citizens of Humanity jeans. These will make your trip much more comfortable. Cotton socks will keep your feet dry and warm regardless of the weather. If you want to purchase something even more comfortable than pants with elastic waistbands, consider buying socks made from cotton. It's time for us to talk about our favorite part of any travel experience, food. Start your day like a Parisian by getting yourself a croissant. Croissants are the perfect breakfast or snack to try in Paris. They come in all sizes, shapes, and flavors, but they all share one important characteristic: they're baked with yeast. The French croissant is loved everywhere. You can find them in bakeries, cafes, and patisseries, but they're sold at street stands throughout the city. The most popular flavors include vanilla and chocolate hazelnut or chocolatine, but there are also savory options like cheese or ham croissants. The best place to buy them is at a local bakery or coffee shop. They'll be fresh right out of the oven and ready for you to devour. Don't leave Paris without trying escargot. Escargots are a popular dish in Paris, especially around Easter and Christmas. They're made by boiling snails with garlic and butter and then serving them with bread and butter. Escargot is French for snails, but they're not snails. They're more like tiny mollusks, often served in the shell. If you want to try them but aren't ready to shell out the cash for a meal, you can find them at street markets or grocery stores. If you're feeling adventurous, check out a restaurant specializing in escargot. You can find one near your hotel if you don't have time to make it yourself. Thanks for watching this video, and if you would like to see more of these videos, hit that like, subscribe, and notification bell to keep these videos coming. Until next time, au revoir!